Hi, welcome back to my channel. Today I decided to share with you what I plan to use in 2024. The thumbnail makes it look as if I have a lot of planners, which I do, but they're not all brand new. Quite a few of them will be planners that I've been using here in 2023 that I plan to carry on using in 2024. So the first one I'm going to be using is my Happy Planner. I've taken the main guts of it out. So this is one that I've used earlier this year, and I really love the cover for all the pet portraits on it. In here, I plan to keep track of our bills. At a year's glance, you can tell how much you paid every single month for whatever bill you want to track. And then down here, I have it blank in case I need to add something that I wasn't expecting. And I can write it down here that, I don't know, let's pretend I had a hospital bill in March, and then I can write it down. So that's what this looks like. This will be for anything that I decide to buy in 2024 that is stationery related. This is my TBR list, which I haven't started yet. This is my husband's TBR list. I've been keeping track of the audiobooks that I've been checking out for him. Keeping track of our cars. So in this case, my car got a new battery, air filter. Like I said, this one says 2022. I know we changed the air filter this year. We can't decide or agree on the month. So for now, I'm gonna leave this here, but this will be for 2024. So anything house related, I will be putting it down here on a page. These are Happy Planner papers that I purchased on sale. And so I just been using them. I plan to use them because I have a lot of these. This is a Coach Planner. In here, I have been using it as a commonplace book. This is a book that I purchased from Michael's really cheaply. Now this is my food, I guess, rating system. Candy, I'm still using it. I rarely share this just because I keep track of the food places that we go to. I take pictures and then I would rate the restaurant. Go to my traveler's notebook. I've been using this as, so this is passport size. I've been using this as my wallet. And really quick, I will show you that I have the passport diary, which is the monthly layout. So this is for the month of December. And I've used just a little bit of stamps and then birthdays, but you can kind of see how I've been using it. And then the second one I've been using, I, in here, created a little food checklist that's gonna look like this. So I've written on the other page restaurants that we want to visit. I can look at one of the restaurants I've written, see if we're craving that, go and visit it, and then I can check it off. So there's that. And then in the back here is my driver's license. I don't think I have a credit card, but they're all back here. In here, this is Traveler's Notebook, the Diner Edition. I've been keeping track of my weight, my stats, my meals, but this is what I did last week. And if you watched my other videos, this is what I was practicing in the Hobonichi weeks. And this is a little bit bigger than the Hobonichi week. I've been keeping track of my sleep, so I made this column a little bit wider. This week's layout. So there's that. Another traveler's notebook, airlines. I've been keeping track of my writing ideas. So I can't really share much in here with you of what I've been doing, but I will show you this. In here, I've cut out pictures of magazines of what I've imagined, what the setting, somebody's house, the neighborhood looks like. That writing tips and notes, so I have that in this one. In book one, I put down people's names, scenes, ideas, maps. I've drawn layouts of the houses of the city that I'm working in. In here, this is for book two. And then just I put names in here too that I've might like for one of my characters. So there's that. And then lastly, this is a traveler's notebook that I purchased from Amazon. And then here is my gardening journal. So I need to finish this one up for 2023 and start one up for 2024. But just to give you an idea, I've taken pictures of my plants, my house plants, and even some vegetables and fruit seeds that I started, and then I will mark it down. This is my A6. This is called, I think, the Life. Nope, this one's called Camp. I purchased this, I think, in 2021. This is my diary, so you're not gonna see anything in here. I will show you my monthly layout. I've been using it as my gratitude, daily gratitude. So this is for December, washi, and then some thin stickers. And so every day I try to find something positive that I can write about. And so that's what I did here. And then the rest of the daily pages will just be diary entries. So this is my camp. Let's put him here. Now this one is one that I don't show often because I haven't read much. This is, if I can get the dog fur off of it, this is my boy and dog cover. I love this cover. I love the colors, and I'm not a very colorful person when it comes to clothing and stuff. I just love this thing. In here, I have my reading journal. And so what I've done, and I've repurposed an A6. I guess we'll start here. Legends and Lattes. Okay, that was from 2022. So as you can see, I drew the cover of the book on my A6 repurposed. I covered the dates up with washi tape for some of them. And then like the sayings down here. So this was for 2022. And of course, the opinions in here are my own. I'm sure if you read the books, you would have your own rating. Okay, here it is. So here's 2023, first book I read. So you can see what I did. So this was kind of fun to do, and it was pretty hard to draw quite a few of them. Like that's the seance in apartment 10, find him where you left him dead, final thoughts. Episode 13. I still haven't written my thoughts on it because I did DNF the book. Bookshop and Bone Dust. That was not too bad. Was that the last book I read? Yep. So for 2024, I will probably put it here and then start whatever book I decide to read in January. So this I will continue using because I have that much more to go to finish up my repurposed A6. Here, this is the 1000 Sunny Logbook, A5 size. I purchased this on sale. I did not do an unboxing of this guy. But in here, I keep my A5 Hun, Tiny Dragon. And then down here, I don't know if you can see this, I added two little charms. So let me show you the first one. This is from Alicia. From Facebook, she purchased this for her tiny dragon. I just love it. So I went ahead and attached it to this book. And then this is from my father-in-law's celebration of life. I have one on my wallet in my traveler's notebook that you can see right there. And so I decided to attach the second one to my hun. So I slipped it in. So it fits fine, as you can see. And this will be my writer's notebook, where I will be keeping track of my word count, my ideas, what I'm doing daily for my writing. I am hoping to finish my rough draft in the first quarter next year. And I just love the pattern. I find this very inspiring for my story writing, which is why I decided to pair them up. The cover on cover that I purchased for this, I went ahead and set aside, and at the end of 2024, I will slip the cover on cover onto this and then slip in the next hun in here, because I'm pretty sure this is what I'm going to do moving forward with my writer's notebook in here, this combo. I just really like it. Now, this is my dog cover here. This will be my normal cousin daily dump, where I will be putting down my thoughts, whatever fun things that happen in here with photos, stickers, washi tape, I plan to do in here. So this is not gonna change too much. I guess we'll slip him down here. And then the last thing I want to share with you, this is my Vacancies A5 size. I've been using this as my doodling sketching for 2023. I just love this cover too. This guy is so soft. And in here, I have my 5-year Hobonichi. And I really should do a flip of this. I haven't done much in here in the past few months. My mom fell in late October, and I sort of fell into a funk of not wanting to do much of anything. And unfortunately, this took a hit where I didn't journal. So I would write down whatever interesting thing that I find. I will draw, list it, and then I've also have been keeping track of the weather. So this will give you an idea of some of the things that I drew. This is a bald eagle. It takes 5 years for the bald eagle to mature. And so I was keeping track of the drawings of what it looks like. And what I decided to do for pages where I didn't draw anything for the year, I will just do two for 2024. So like on March 11 in 2024, I will pick two things to draw and fill it in, and then make note over here that I drew it in 2024. And I'm hoping at the end, in 2027, I can see a progress of my drawing. That is the idea. I'm hoping it'll work. This is when I was on a bird kick. I draw in pencil, as you can see here. And then I will either, this is where I didn't do anything. So I draw in pencil. And then I will either write over that with black Hobonichi ink from the pen that we get, or I will use a no bleed black pen marker. And then I want watercolor. So but I've been having a lot of fun drawing. I was having a lot of fun drawing. Well, these are extinct animals that are no longer around. But anyways, so that's what this guy looks like. And again, for blank pages, this was Hobonichi challenges for the month of October. They did lighthouses. But yeah, not too much more. But hopefully next week, when at the start of the month, I will get back into this. And if I remember, I will try and do a flip through of this guy. So this is all that I'm planning to use for 2024. Again, it looks like a lot. Really, it's not, I don't think. I guess we'll see. We'll see how much I can keep up with it. Hopefully, I'll be able to daily draw in here. And then I always, you know, do this. This is my diary. So I think it's going to work out. I think it'll be fine. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see after the pin videos, generally, of my Hobonichi cousin. And I guess I will see you next year. Bye.